Okay, year 10. So we're going to have a look at the first topic from year 11. It's called classification and biodiversity. So we look at how we group plants and animals, how we classify them. We look at their Latin name, adaptations, what plants and animals need to survive and what they compete for. Then we look into what biodiversity is, how we can protect it, how we can measure it using sampling techniques, something called capture and recapture, which is higher tier only. And then we'll finish off with biological control agents. So we'll start at the top, how we group plants and animals. So plants are quite easy in the sense that they've only really got two groups. We've got the flowering plants, and basically they make flowers. So I don't know, something like a rose. And then we've got plants that don't make flowers. They're non-flowering. So something like ferns, mosses. Now animals, there's a little bit more detail to look at. So animals are split into the invertebrates and the vertebrates. Now invertebrates have no backbone. Or no vertebrata. Vertebrates have a backbone, such as us. And there are five main vertebrate groups. There are the fish, there are the birds, the reptiles, the mammals, and the amphibians. Fish tend to have, they've got cold blood, they've got gills, and they swim. Birds are warm-blooded, they have wings, and they're covered in feathers. Reptiles have cold blood and dry, scaly skin and lay eggs. Mammals have warm blood and are covered in fur. And amphibians are cold-blooded, and they can live both in land and in water. So we've got two main groups of plants. We've got the flowering and the non-flowering. Got two big groups of animals, the invertebrates and the vertebrates. Invertebrates being things like bugs, insects. And the vertebrates are split into five groups: the fish, the birds, the reptiles, the mammals, and the amphibians.